survey from the Council of American Islamic Relations found that 40% of Michigan's Muslim American voting population planned to back Green Party candidate Jill Stein. 18% plan to support President Trump. 12% want VP Harris, and 4% plan to vote for Cornel West. This seems pretty significant, Kyle, specifically after more than 100,000 voters in Michigan in the primary voted uncommitted. Is this a massive red flag for the Harris campaign, given that there's only about 7 weeks until Election Day?
It is, and for a couple reasons. I mean, think about the mainstream coverage of Donald Trump and Muslims. It is 100% negative. And so the fact that this poll shows, and it's a CARE poll, which, you know, CARE does not like Donald Trump, but the fact that this poll shows that more Michigan Muslims support Donald Trump than supports Kamala Harris is, that is major. But then when you look at the top line of the poll, and it shows that 40% of Michigan Muslims support Jill Stein, to me, that is major red flags for Harris. And there's been a lot of coverage about the fact that is RFK going to be on the ballot? Is he not going to be on the ballot in Michigan? Cornel West, as RFK was put back on the ballot, Cornel West was also put on the ballot. And so he theoretically is going to take votes away from Kamala Harris. But she has a major problem with Michigan Muslims because they don't like what Biden has done. And she, of course, has, in their opinion, has not been outspoken enough. And so this is a very significant problem for her because there are hundreds of thousands of Muslims who are very paying attention to what is going on. And so I think what we'll see is that this is going to get worse if it ever gets better, because there's a group, there was a group of uncommitted Muslims who wanted to sort of, you know, make their point in not for voting for Joe Biden. Well, they have now sort of rebranded, and they are now considering themselves Abandon Harris, and they're actually looking at supporting another candidate. And if you, again, if you look at the polling from CARE, their natural choice would be Jill Stein, because 40% in that responded to the poll support Jill Stein. And so this is a storyline that I think cannot be understated, that it is very possible that this could.
So folks, breaking news. This is absolutely huge. You just saw that little the clip beforehand talking about the Muslim vote, the Arab American vote in Dearborn, Michigan, and also across the land. Folks, I have been talking about this on my show, been saying this for so many days now, months, that Donald Trump was going to fight for every single vote everywhere across the United States of America. He wants to be the president for everyone. He's looking for votes from Hispanics, Latinos, Asians, Blacks, Christians, Muslims, Jews, atheists, agnostics, you know, Catholics, born again. I mean, he's asking for the vote, folks. He's going there and asking. Kamala Harris is not going there asking. She's not doing anything at all. And folks, this is an absolute bombshell. This is the mayor, Amir Ghalib, the mayor of, I hope I'm pronouncing the town right. It's Hamtramck, Hamtramck. They are a Muslim majority town. They also have I think they're the only town in America that is a Muslim majority city council. And then when you take that with their sister city, Dearborn, Michigan, which has about 150,000 Arabs living there, 70% Muslim Arabs, American Muslim Arabs, about 30% of the Arab population is Christian. Coming from, you know, the same places, same country, Syria, Lebanon, Morocco, Egypt, Sub-Saharan Africa, Jordan, UAE, they're an eclectic mix. Also coming from, you know, Indonesia and Malaysia and Pakistan, it's an eclectic group, but the majority is Arab dominated, obviously. And now the mayor, Amir Gharib, now Trump did this about a week ago. He had a meeting with his father-in-law, all right? His daughter, Tiffany, is married to a Lebanese businessman's son, Michael Boussat. I have to get the last name right or whatever. But he was sort of like the go-between here, all right? So Tiffany, his daughter's father-in-law, a Lebanese multi-billionaire entrepreneur businessman, 2 years ago, I guess, you know, he got married. So don't tell me that Trump, okay, is against Arabs or against Jews. He's racist. That's just a bunch of bullshit, folks. It's bullshit. I mean, his children are Jewish. He's got a Jewish son-in-law. Now he's got a Lebanese-American son-in-law. Oh, my goodness. You know what? It just, you guys got to stop with the racism. It's over. It's 2024. All right? That R card's been played. The B card, the bigot, the bigot. That card's been played. Nobody's looking at the card anymore. They just tear it up and rip it up. Throw it away. Let's get a little bit more into this, folks, a little bit more into the details here. This is absolute. Michigan just turned, as I was saying, for many, many months that she had no chance. The mainstream media, the legacy media, they're not playing on this at all. They're not talking about this. And then Jill Stein is in this here too, folks. Check this thing out. Jill Stein is polling 40%. 40% in Michigan. She wasn't there in 2020. She was there in 2016. And it made it possible, took enough votes away from Hillary Clinton and votes away from Donald Trump, but possibly more from Hillary Clinton, that allowed Trump to capture Michigan in 2016. And now, and that was in Jill Stein, as I said, she was on the ballot. They didn't allow her to go on the ballot in 2020, which was a travesty. It wasn't democracy, that was fascism. They said, no, you can't get on the ballot. Now in 2024, she is getting 40%. Trump's at 18%, folks, without this on the care poll. On the care poll all over America, Trump's around 12. Stein and Harris are both at 29. Okay, you can expect that. I'm not expecting every single Muslim or a plurality or a majority, 70, 80% Muslims across America. I'd love that. Come with me, brother. Come with me. But they're not going to do that. But he doesn't need to do it across America. He just needs to do it in the battleground states. In Nevada, he's at 27% Muslim vote. Harris is at 29. Here in Michigan, though, one of the prize of prizes, one of the three of the blue walls, Stein 40, Trump 18. And Harris is at 12. And this is before the endorsement, folks, and before this. So here it goes. Former President Donald Trump told Breitbart News exclusively that he's excited that Amir Gharib, the Muslim Democrat, this is a Muslim Democrat mayor, folks, a Democrat mayor of Hamtramck. I know I'm botching this, and I've got to find out, and I should have. My apologies to find out how do you pronounce the name of the city. Hamtramck. Endorses campaign for president against VP Kamala Harris. Now, here's his reasoning. Amir says, I was very impressed with him, and he was a very big fan of the Trump administration because he saw no wars outside defeating ISIS. But I inherited that. But there were no wars, Trump told Breitbart News in an exclusive interview Sunday. There was no October 7th. There was no Russian attack on Ukraine. He sees that. He told me he saw the world was at peace. Now we have a world that's going to end up in World War III, and Trump says, I can stop that. I'm the only one that's going to stop that. Trump had a nearly hour-long phone interview with Breitbart, said he's very open to go. As I said before, he was going to go. They're going to go to Amtrak, folks. They're going to go to Dearborn, Michigan for a campaign event and meet with the leaders of the Arab American community who are upset with the failures of Harris and Biden's administration. The answer is, if the opportunity presents itself, I would do it. Obviously, there's, you know, you've got to find a building, to, you know, where are you going to have this location. Security protocols have to be met. I mean, there's all kinds of logistics, but they can start working on it and have something really, really good. But you know what? They need to go in there soon, too, because early voting is starting. He said Trump, when asked if he would hold a rally or campaign stop in Hamtramck, he says it can't remain the way it is now with the hatred that's going around. So Ghalib, the mayor of Hamtramck, is also a Democrat. He's a Yemeni immigrant, represents one of the biggest Muslim communities in Wayne County, Michigan. Population is 60% Muslim. Ghalib was one of the leaders of the effort to get Muslim Democrats to vote uncommitted against Biden earlier this year in the Democratic primary. That movement transformed first into Abandon Biden that was being led. There's a woman out there, I can't remember her name, but there was a Dr. Abdul Hassan Salam, who is also part of the Abandon Biden, which in turn the Abandon Harris. And their whole thing was, no, we're not uncommitted. That's not what they were. They were there for to say, we are going to take down the Biden administration. We're going to take down Harris. We don't want her to be president. We're going to do everything legally in our power. If that means voting in Trump or voting third party or staying at home, it doesn't matter. That's what we're going to do. We don't want these genocidal freaks in the Biden administration and the Kamala Harris administration. We don't want these genocidal Joes. Now, Ghalib appeared on Breitbart News Saturday, and people are always talking about my friends and colleagues. Oh, my goodness, you're in this community in North Carolina. Oh, God, these people, I know so many of them. And a lot of them are changing, folks. A lot of people in the Muslim community have come silently up to me and say, Nasser, we're voting for Trump this time. You were right. You were right. We apologize. We just thought that, you know, whatever the reasons were. But the economy was better. Safety and security was better. Our 401k was better. Our job situation was better. We were making more money. All these things, illegals were pouring aboard. Now these things are happening. The Indian community is also the same way. You would think the Indian community would rally after Kamala Harris, but Kamala Harris doesn't consider herself to be South Indian or Indian anymore. She considers to be black. Black. She be black, Jake. And that's a matter of fact, Jake. No, it's not. Now, let's go over here. So, every time I throw Breitbart News at my friends here, all everywhere, right? That right-wing crap you just keep sending us, you know? And the same story appears someplace else, although not in big bold. If it was on Yahoo News, they would have, but Yahoo News, you think they're doing the same type of story? Hell no! They're not doing that at all! So Ghalib, he appears on Breitbart News. He spoke very highly of Trump. And at that time, he didn't endorse him. So this is a week ago going back, okay? Ghalib told Breitbart News that he had a very productive meeting last week in Flint. But what he knew about Trump was he does not want new wars if and when he is elected president again. So his quote is now, he says, Ghalib, the mayor of Hamtramck, says, I talked to President Trump about, you know, some statistics in Wayne County and how it used to be a stronghold for the Democrat. We always used to vote Democrat. That's not the case anymore. Then Sunday afternoon, Trump speaking with Breitbart, Ghalib formally drops the bomb. That's right, folks. He drops it. And he says he endorses Trump for president, making a monumental, folks, a monumental shift among Arab voters against Democrats. And remember, these Arab voters, not all of them, as I said, they're not all Muslim. 70% are. Many of them are Christian, Catholics, different denominations, or Coptic Christians from Egypt. You've got Christians from Jordan, Syria, Lebanon, Morocco. I mean, they're, yes, minorities there, but they have come to the United States. They're second, third, fourth generation here right now. Trump highlighted the endorsement, and here's how it goes. Ladies and gentlemen, this is from the mayor, Amir Ghalib. Ladies and gentlemen, let me be clear so our expectations are realistic. President Trump and I may not agree on everything, but I know he is a man of principles. Bingo! JFK, they said the same thing, remember? RFK, I mean, sorry. RFK said the same thing. We may not agree on everything, but there are certain things that we can agree upon. Let's do the things that we agree upon. Though it's looking good, He may or may not win the election, be the 47th president of the United States, but I believe he is the right choice for this critical time. He goes on to say, folks, I'll not regret my decision no matter what the outcome would be, and he's ready to face the consequences. For this and many other reasons, I announce my support and endorsement of the former and hopefully the next president of the United States, Donald Trump. Now let the caravan begin its journey, and he goes on and on. Now it says here, as I said before, if even a fraction of this community breaks with Harris and joins Ghalib, it will prove devastating to Harris's electoral prospects. Folks, she's lost Michigan completely. It's gone now, folks, gone. Again, well over 100,000 Michigander Arabs voted uncommitted, which was nearly the full margin between Biden and Trump in the 2020 Michigan election, which we know all had its, you know. The loss of this key Democratic voting bloc for Harris could swing the state. And they don't even mention Jill Stein in this article. I know they've talked about it before, but Jill Stein is there. And then there's also Cornel West to take, you know, votes away too. So it was Pennsylvania. Michigan is going. Wisconsin is falling. Pennsylvania is falling. Folks, this is so huge. I've talked about it. I predicted it. I told you this was going to happen. Unbelievable huge news, folks. Unbelievable huge news. Anyways, you've been watching the Dr. Nasser Shake Show. I'm your host, Dr. Nasser. If you haven't done so already, subscribe to the channel, like, share, and follow us. Check out our links to our other videos that we talked about this. Future things going on. We're going to be covering this story. Wait till the news cycle hits this on Monday, and it's in the Twitterverse. It already is there, folks. Check out our other video links above and below. My final thought is always, when you're right, you're right. And when you're left, you're wrong. And I'm Amir Ghalib, mayor of Hamtramck. He's so right. And the Harris campaign, they're so left because they're so wrong. Until next time, folks, take care and stay safe.